Welcome back today, friends, and as you can see, we have our work cut out for us on this snow day. The day that I'm filming this is actually day 3 of a snowstorm that we had in our area, and you can see the evidence of that. We were really good the first 2 days of coming in and out. I had a laundry basket that I kept by the kitchen door, and they piled their wet stuff there. But you can see here we are, late afternoon of day 3, and we were done. And we knew a deep house cleaning was coming, so we were saving our extra cleaning energy for that. Hallway, things are just strung about. There's someone's underwear, but I believe it's clean underwear that got pulled out from the laundry. And then here's the homeschool room, dining room, and even though I did a deep cleaning on this a few days before, it needed a pickup and a tidy. And I'm also working on a big batch of spaghetti sauce. Now I have about 5 pounds of the pasture-raised ground beef, and of course a variety of peppers, how I do it, and a few cans of mushrooms I had in my pantry. I had let the meat cook in that over the last few hours, so here I am just breaking it up. Many times what I end up doing is just using the spatula or whatever tool I have on hand. I don't want to get extra utensils dirty, and many times a spatula is all I've had, so that's why I just use what I have on hand. So here I'm picking up for lunch. For lunch, I had made the last of the freezer burritos that we had in one of our extra freezers, and I also chopped 3 whole pineapple. And so I'm bagging that up, but then I get a request for more, and look, I get to feed my grown man, grown son Jaden. And so right now I'm just working on an all-over pickup tidy. All the children, let's see, we have Gabriel and Liam, are in their bedroom doing their deep cleaning on their room. So what I'm doing right now is getting the stickers off and piercing the spaghetti squash. Obviously that looks like a bloody murder knife, so be careful, but I pierce them and cook them whole. I have a recent video I did where I cook spaghetti squash, and we did this creamy cheesy chicken bake, and I will link that down in the description below. So here, this is how I usually drain big batches of ground beef. I'll put a colander inside another pot and then just mash my meat down and let it drain. The Aldi spaghetti sauce, it's so cheap. It's like 85 cents a jar, and it's pretty decent ingredients. So if I don't have what I need on hand to make true homemade spaghetti sauce, I just go with the Aldi sauce because it works out fantastic. So what I'm doing now is putting a little bit of water in each of the jars, and I will shake each jar and get each last little scrapes of sauce out of it. A few days ago, I came out with a new video, and it was Cook With Me, and it was a big batch of weekend tacos. And I had a few comments of ladies wondering, oh my goodness, if my family ate all 5 pounds of ground beef in one meal. And I'm sorry for the confusion. What I meant by that video is I was doing a big cook up on Saturday, and then we ate those tacos until Monday. So that was 5 pounds of taco meat plus the black beans, and we had that as our main meals for 5 to 6 meals for 10 people. So that 5 pounds of ground beef was not one meal. It was very stretched out. And this big spaghetti cookup I was doing, it's another big similar cookup. If I don't have freezer meals available, what I do, I naturally go to batch cooking and bulk cooking, where I make a huge amount of something that my family loves, and we just eat it over a few days until it's gone. During this cleaning time, of course, I saw so many things that needed a deep decluttering, but I also wanted to do decluttering of 2 areas. I wanted to get under my kitchen sink completely, and I wanted to get my bathroom laundry shelves, because like you know, we manage laundry for 10 out of a laundry closet, and as I always say, we're so thankful to have a washer and dryer, so I'm not complaining. I'm taking everything out from under the kitchen cabinet, and I'm going to use my vinegar spray this time mainly. I spray out everything. Oh, and let me tell you this too. You may have just seen a plunger fly by. That plunger is marked kitchen, and that is only for the kitchen sink. And I think Travis has only had to use it 1, maybe 2 times, but still, obviously, If you have a plunger under your kitchen sink, you want to make sure it stays there and mark it appropriately. So I spray out the bottom with the vinegar spray. Many mamas ask me if the vinegar spray smells like vinegar. Sure, it sure does. But you can also add a few drops of essential oils to it. Now I am washing out my Instant Pot that I had used the day before, letting that soak, and it's spaghetti squash time. You will see Zion is in the background. In addition to all the jackets we had stacked up, he just went ahead and took everything out of that closet and did a good deep organizing on it. He does that for me about once a week during our cleaning time. It's super helpful. What I have done here is I've put all the spaghetti squash insides into a bowl, and I'm going to fill that bowl also with the meat sauce. So I'm mixing it up well, and then I'm filling my shells. I will eat the spaghetti squash this way. My girls will sometimes eat spaghetti squash. I don't have too many other folks interested in spaghetti squash. When my mom is visiting, she'll eat it. Here I am with the controversial cheese topping, getting it in the oven, and then I just let it bake for about 10 to 15 minutes on a low heat, long enough to melt the cheese. And so what was a little difficult on this during this cleaning time is I was all, you know, full steam ahead, clean, declutter, and the kids had been cleaning, but guess what? Everybody needs to eat. So I took some time here to make plates and serve out spaghetti. Okay, here it is, finally. So here I am shuffling my laundry, as I call it, getting another load going. My first goal anytime I do any kind of decluttering project is I get everything out of the area. So I just pull down all the bottles, all the sprays, the glass vases, the furniture polish, you know, everything I have that's taking up space on these shelves. There are even some cleaning items on there, like the bleach pens and I think some like hornet spray and some other odds and ends that were left here by the prior owners. So it was really time. We have cleaned these shelves off a few times over the last few years, but I never actually threw things away and got rid of things. So in this decluttering, I was getting rid of things. So I got everything off and I sprayed those shelves off, all three, with vinegar. Now I'm organizing a haul of Mrs. Meyer's cleaning products I just got from Grove Collaborative. There will also be a link in the description below if you would like to get some of those yourself. And so here is the final result. Boy, those shelves look nice and tidy and organized. Okay, now this kitchen and these dishes. And it is past bedtime now. So this total cleaning, organizing, cooking was over many hours throughout the evening. And so now we're at the point where kids have already gone to bed. And what I like to do when this happens, you see that man smiling at you on the TV? That is Mr. Keith Green. Keith Green was an amazing worship leader in the 70s and the 80s. I rock out to Keith Green worship music, especially if it's like 11 at night, kids are in bed. I'm packing up the last of the spaghetti sauce, and Zion is running out some trash for me. Here is the overhead view of me getting after all these dishes. So I'm loading this dishwasher, and once I can find some room in there, I leave some water in that I can just reuse to do a quick rinse, so I'm not like truly washing the dishes before we wash the dishes. But I do try to just rinse them off, especially when you're doing lots of heavy cooking. You have to get chunks of food and such off of those pans. And then many of the bigger pots and pans I hand wash. And now I'm going after my countertops, minus that one little stack of toys of Daniel's. And I am spraying everything down with the vinegar spray, taking knobs off my stove, and just really scrubbing down. I don't put the roaster oven up until the following day once I have everything dry and all the components ready to go, so it'll just sit there overnight. So here I'm cleaning the refrigerator off with vinegar spray. I'm not doing a full take everything out and deep clean the inside of it. I don't do that daily or even weekly always. Of course, but I do try to get the outside a few times a week. Many of you have asked me how this refrigerator is holding up. It's a great test. We have not broken any compartments inside or any drawers. So internally, it's holding up well. Externally, it's holding up well, except the things I notice are, and you can probably see this, on the one door without the ice maker, there are a few little dings that show now. and there's a few scratches if you get up close. And the ice maker, I don't know, maybe 3 or 4 times has not worked, and Travis has had to go over there and make it work. But that's my quick report on how it's holding up so far. Now here's the countertops, all fresh. Have my Instant Pot lid left. Here is the, yeah, that's where my phone sits. If I'm washing dishes, those items are drying. And we have the refrigerator shining. At least it looks decent this evening. And this heavily used countertop is all ready to go. And then here is how the homeschool room looks, although I see one piece of fuzz on the floor, but it had a quick tidy. So thank you for watching this large family home deep cleaning. I will see you tomorrow with another brand new video, and I'll talk to you in the comments below. Bye bye.